Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, today we are seeing a new questions supported at different level. Let's see. As a question written over here, question number 4, a suspension cable of horizontal span 95 meter is supported at two different level. Students, first read the question carefully whether it is supported at same level or different level. Now you have just read suspension cable of horizontal span 95 meter, just not simply draw the supported at same level. First listen the questions. Is supported at two different level means your question will be two different levels. Okay, the right support is higher than the left support by 4 meter means your right support is higher than the left support by 4 meter means your this distance will be 4 meter. Okay, your this distance will be 4 meter and your span will be 95 meter. After that, right support is higher than the left support by 4 meter. The dip to the lowest point of the cable below the left support is 5 meter. Means this distance will be 5 meter. Okay, this distance will be 5 meter. The cross section area of the cable, this is new thing in this question. They have given the cross sectional area of the cable. Why it is given? Let's see. Find the uniformly distributed load that can be carried by the cable. In this numerical, you have to find the overall UDL means your P value means your W. If the maximum stress is limited to 600 Newton per mm square means your T max will be also there, nothing but 600 Newton per mm square. Now, as you all know, this is 5 meter. If this is your H1 is 5 meter, so this one will be, this part one will be L1, okay, and this will be L2 means your this part will be H2 is equal to 5 plus 4, 9 meter. Your H2 will be 9 meter. Sir,
level.
Okay, now A will be your first support and this B and then C. Okay, now this will be H1, then this will be L1, this will be L2 and this will be H2. You can change simultaneously also. You can write L2 also, H2 also, H1 and L1. Okay, after that you have to find this value VA and this H. You have to find this VB and H. But in numerical, what you have to find? You have to find the uniformly distributed load that can be carried by the cable. Means you have to find these things. This is your unknown in this numerical. Okay. Means this is your P is unknown. Means to find what we have to find over here? P is unknown. Means UDL over the entire cable. Okay. Now what we have to do first we have to simply apply the formula. First, as you all knows, in this we have given the total L. This is your total L, but not given the L1 and L2. So first we have to find the value of L1 and L2. To find length, we have the formula L1 upon L2 is equal to under root H1 upon H2. Okay, now L1 is equal to under root H1 upon H2 into L2. Now your H1 will be, your H1 will be 5, your H2 will be 9. So under root 5 by 9 into L2. While solving this, you get the value of L1. L1 will be 0.7453 L2. After that, L is equal to L1 plus L2. Okay, now L is nothing but, you have given this L value, L is 95 meter. So 95 is equal to, put the value of L1 over here, 0.74533 plus L2 plus L2. Okay, now you have, while solving this, you get the value of L2 will be 54.43 meter. Okay,
This is your 54.43 meter. After that, L is equal to L1 plus L2, much L value will be 95 is equal to your L1 will be unknown plus L2 will be 54.43 meter. Okay. Now while solving this, you get the value of L1 will be 40.57 meter. Okay, friends. Now we got the value of L1. L1 will be 40.57 meter. And L2 will be 54.43 meter. Okay. Now after that, what we have to see, after we have got the value of L1 and L2, now we have to find the value of VA, HA, VB and HB. Okay. Now what is the formula to find VA? To find VA, our formula will be W into L1. Okay, your W will be nothing but your P into L1. Your L1 distance will be 40.57. L1 distance will be 40.57 equal to, we got the value of VA 40.57 P in Newton, in terms of Newton. Your VB value will be W into L2 is nothing but P into L2 distance is nothing but 54.43 is equal to 54.43 P in Newton. Please remember this P over here, in terms we got the all value in terms of P. Okay, after that your H value, now as you all knows, this is down and this is up, this one is up there, have the tank T max will be over here, not here, so directly we have to solve over here only T max. Then H will be W L2 square upon 2H2. That's why we are taking find the value of H over HB. Okay. So W will be P into L2 will be 54.43 the whole square divided by 2 into H2. H2 is nothing but 9. Okay. Now this will solving this, you get the value 164.65 in terms of P. Okay. Now you have to find the T max, and what is the formula for T max is nothing but TB is equal to VB square plus H square. Okay, now we have to put the value of VB. VB value will be 54.43 P the whole square plus H is nothing but 40.57 P the whole square. Okay, now you are solving this, you get the value of T max will be 173.413 in terms of P. This is your T max. Okay, now T max, we have to find the T max is nothing but 173.413 in terms of P. Now as you all knows, in given in the numerical, we have the given the cross sectional area of the cable is nothing but 3500 and maximum stress limited to 600. Means what is stress? Stress is nothing but P upon A. What is P? P is nothing but force upon that cross sectional area. Then we have to find P. P is equal to stress into area. Now P is equal to stress into area. After that we have to put over T max over here. 173.413 in terms of P is equal to, as you have the sigma value is 600. Then simply draw the 600 into cross sectional area. Cross sectional area will be 3500 mm square, means 3500. Okay, while solving this, you get 600 into 3500 divided by 173.413. okay, now you get the value of P will be 12109 newton per meter. Now you have to convert into kilonewton. 12.10 kilonewton per meter. Now we have find this value. This is our final answer, as we find the value of UDL, means P or W. Thanks for watching my video. Subscribe to Ekeeda channel.